The Windows PC platform has been using an x86 processor since 1981. However, Apple had gone through many changes of architecture, from Motorola CPUs to Intel x86 in 2005, and they released their first Macs with an ARM-based M1 chip in November 2020. In this video, we will talk about the Apple M1 and its advantages, and what makes it different from Intel processors used in previous MacBooks. Quick disclaimer, we're not here to advertise Apple's products, and this is not a review. You can find many videos like that on the web. Welcome to the Modern Day Geeks, where we talk about gaming, tech, film, and everything under the sun. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on all our future videos. Wait, what is CPU, you say? A CPU is a tiny chip that serves as the brain of your device. It is an essential part of any computing system, such as laptops, desktops, smartphones, and even gaming consoles. It stands for Central Processing Unit. For laptops and desktops, infamous brands like Intel and AMD are primarily used as CPUs. For years, Intel had been monopolizing the market of CPUs, especially for portable computers. During the 90s, a brand called PowerPC tried to unseat Intel, but failed eventually. In the modern world, Intel's market share dropped to 74%. One of the many factors for this huge Intel dominance is because Apple used to make their MacBooks using an Intel CPU, and then their new chip debuted in 2020. The M1 is the first Apple-designed system on chip, replacing the x86 for their products. With Apple's new M1 chip, that 74% will decrease even further over time. But this chip monopoly isn't actually the reason why Apple creates its own chip for their laptops. Well, what are the reasons? The first reason is no more overheating issues. Phew! Since the chips do a lot of work, heat is almost unavoidable. Overheating doesn't just cause discomfort on your lap, but it also slows down your system because the system would intentionally reduce the process in your computer in order to maintain the right amount of temperature, while also increasing fan noise in order to remove heat. MacBooks made before 2020 are built on Intel processors. For years, overheating has been a problem for some people and in some countries. With the Apple M1, their goal is to remove the heat issue to provide more comfort and performance to Apple MacBook users. It is also tailor-made for Apple products, making it more exclusive. The iPhones, iPads, and even Apple smartwatches have had their own Apple chips since then. The iPhone 4 had the A4 chip. The Apple chips were designed to be high performance, have less overheating issues, and are more energy efficient. However, the MacBooks were using Intel. There were no Apple chips made for them. In November 2020, they introduced the Apple M1, which gave newer MacBooks their very own Apple chipset, but one that only supports up to 16 GB of RAM, which is good for casual users, but might be lacking for some art creators. The more recent Apple M1 Max, which was released in October 2021, supports more RAM, up to 64 GB, which is perfect for multitasking and many professional artists. With the new chipset, the MacBook display would turn on instantly, as it would on your iPad or iPhone. No more loading, no more black screen. You'll never have to be surprised to suddenly see the reflection of your face again when loading. Hey, wait, before we continue, hit that like and subscribe button if you haven't done it yet. Okay, continuing. The new M1 chip has lower energy consumption yet higher performance. Usually, a processor that is higher performance tends to consume more energy. This is why processors and laptops have less performance than their desktop counterparts. With Apple M1, this logic is defied. The M1 chip has more than tripled the amount of performance compared to the counterpart laptop chip of another brand. Yet only one quarter of M1's energy consumption is enough to match the top speed of the rival brand. How fast? Like crazy fast! Its built-in GPU is 6 times faster than any other integrated GPUs in a laptop. We get more performance with less energy consumption. Thus, we also get more battery life. Pretty awesome if you ask me. Lastly, MacBook price versus Windows laptop. It used to be that with the same performance, laptops built on Windows are relatively cheaper than Apple MacBooks. It used to be that people who wanted performance chose PC laptops, while people who wanted elegance, comfort, and something lightweight preferred MacBooks. However, the release of the new M1 changed everything. the price upon release of the M1 MacBooks are the same as the Intel models released before, yet this time, it's way faster with the M1 chips. Thus, you might reconsider your options when buying for performance per price. In summary, the new M1 is revolutionary for making different chips instead of Intel x86. It's energy efficient, has more performance, and is relatively more affordable. Thus, the next time you're considering a performance laptop, try to reconsider the MacBooks. What do you think about Apple's M1 chip? Let us know in the comments below and tell us what you want us to talk about next. Don't forget to leave a like and hit that subscribe button. We're the Modern Day Geeks, and we'll see you in the next video.